This guy.
The only haters I've got time for are the haters that hate on my haters.
Pop star, now play.
Oh, good, you got it. Is it 100% loose down?
Yes.
Sure?
Why do you need this?
I sleep over at John's house every year for his birthday.
Okay, that's not creepy.
I guess it is a little creepy. When a young man who happens to be an only child loses both of his parents in a tragic accident 1 month before his birthday, and then has a best friend make a vow that he will never spend his birthday alone again. Maybe that would fall under the category of
30 seconds until minions spawned.
I'm so sorry.
That's okay.
No, you're really sweet. I've got the perfect girl for you.
Janice, I apologize to you if I don't seem real eager to jump into a forced, awkward, intimate situation that people like to call dating. I don't like the feeling. You're sitting there, you're wondering, do I have food on my face? Am I talking too much? Are they talking enough? Am I interested? I'm not really interested. Should I play like I'm interested, but I'm not that interested? But I think she might be interested, but do I want to be interested? But now she's not interested. So now all of a sudden I'm starting to get interested. Where am I supposed to kiss her? Do I have to wait for the door? Because then it's awkward. It's like, well, good night. Do you like the ass out hug? Or you like you hug each other like this and the ass sticks out because you're trying not to get too close? You just go right in and kiss them on the lips or don't kiss them at all. It's very difficult trying to read the situation. And all the while, you're just really wondering, are we going to get hopped up enough to make some bad decisions? Perhaps play a little game called Just a Tip. Just for a second. Just a second. Or pouch out, you're on my hair.
Bring me a real
hand.
Okay, can you put that so he can't see it? And thank you. Hey, Janice. Great talk.
Every mistake.
John?
Yeah.
I gotta see you right away. It's important.
My journey.
You got 3 weeks ahead of us. It's wedding season, kid.
Sandbagging son of a bitch.
I got us down for 17 of them already.
Okay, now how many of them are cash poor?
Great question. Look where your head's at. And 2 of them actually are. But I got us covered. Purple hearts. We wanted to pay for a drink.
My place is at the top.
Yeah, perfect. We are going to have tons and tons of opportunities to meet gorgeous ladies that are so aroused by the thought of marriage that they'll throw their inhibitions to the wind.
And who's going to be there to catch them?
Grab that neck and kiss that beautiful butterfly, pal. What do you like better, Christmas or wedding season?
Mr. Gray.
Yes. The answer would be, wedding season?
Bingo. I'm gonna go get my suit.
Holy cow, who are we this time?
Hey, Lou Epstein, I want you to meet a real Mitch, Chuck Schwartz.
Stop. As we carry on the tradition of thousands of years, we honor the eternal bond that stretches through the ages.
Adapt to all situations.
I have known this couple many years. That brother has actually owned my entire life. I was at her house.
My journey is only beginning.
Okay.
that's the girl I'm going to marry. I now pronounce you man and wife.
Know what this school is for.
Growing a fatty.
No, not for a junior man. Well, you're a whole combination. You got the frosties in the middle and on the other
end. You both look beautiful up there today, particularly Debbie. In that white dress. Enjoy it. After tomorrow, I don't think you're going to be able to get away with wearing a white dress.
How does he pick this off?
We need a leader.
In the words of the old country,
Mahayam.
Never said it.
Aren't you scared?
I say yes.
Sanjay Collins.
Chuck Pendulum. Excited to be here.
James O'Toole.
Bobby O'Shea.
I'm ready to get this.
I think that's just Kit Leonard. Diabetic.
Who's that?
That's a Luigi and a genius son of Christopher. You're not the banker.
So here's what happened on episode 7 of the first season of Angie Tribeca.
My name's Vic Deacons, but you can call me Vic Deacons.
First, Angie needed a break.
The job is getting to you. You're wound too tight.
I could kill you for saying that.
So Giles and Tanner decided to partner up.
So what are we doing here? Are we partners or what?
Why do you have to put a label on everything? In France, cops have all kinds of partners and no one thinks twice.
To investigate the death of a golf pro.
How'd he die?
His brain and heart stopped. After that, he had no chance.
Then Scholes found something on his balls.
There's something unusual about his balls.
What are those little letters?
They're monograms.
S.S.
Samantha Stevens.
And then Cecily Strong offered them a mimosa.
I'm sorry, come again?
Still not getting it?
Ah, mimosa. Yes, we'll take two, please.
And then she said,
bring my heart detectors. My husband had nothing to do with it.
Which, of course, meant that he totally did it.
Mr. Stevens, you're under arrest for the murder of Riley Hale.
And that's what happened on Angie Tribeca.
You're not the banker.
Oh, that's my new adopted son, Granny, the veterinarian.
Change for a new gen.
Executed. We lost a lot of good men out there.
Wow, really? Mount Everest?
I don't like to talk about it because we lost so many good men out there.
Holy
lost so many good men out there.
Playing with the Yankees?
Yes, with the Yankees, you lose good men to trades and unruly fans. I don't want to talk about it. I'm sorry.
Tattoo on the lower back. So I'll be a boss.
You know how they say we only use 10% of our brains? I think we only use 10% of our hearts.
You're so tiny in your arms.
Every mistake.
Really? How tall are you?
6'5".
Jabroni.
You're complete. 50%.
bet that blonde was a real shot of life.
Yeah.
Real shot.
That's not what
no. One day you'll look back on all this and laugh. Say we were young and stupid. Couple of dumb kids running around.
Not that young.
Enemy killing spree. Every mistake is a lesson.
Hell of a season, Ben.
Hell of a season.
Enemy rampage.
My place
is an ally has been slain.
Oh, Baba Ganoush.
Secretary Cleary?
I'm the Secretary of the Treasury, the guy you love since business school. Don't thank me.
Oh, man, I thought the season was over. I was looking forward to kind of taking a break for a little bit.
This is the Kentucky Derby of weddings. It's the Clearys. They're an American institution. Hell, there's going to be over 200 single women at this wedding. Not to mention, if you look here, they got three live bands. They got oysters, snacks, phenomenal finger food. I'm tired. And my feet hurt. My voice is hoarse. Please don't take a turn.
It's getting negative.
Fuck your nuptials. Yeah.
So here's what happened on episode one of the first season of Angie Tribeca. First, the lieutenant wanted to see Angie.
But he doesn't look happy.
He never looks happy.
Buckner nuptials, you were sitting and sulking in the corner.
I wasn't sulking. I twisted my ankle.
Rule number six. Do not sit in the corner and sulk. It draws attention to you in a negative way. Draw attention to yourself.
Never
sit on your own.
You make it sound like a cult, okay? And from everything you've told me about Chaz, he sounds like a kook.
You bite your tongue. Chaz Reinhold is not a kook. He's a brave, decent pioneer.
This motherfucker is 40. He can't do poisonous oatmeal.
Erroneous! Erroneous! Erroneous on both counts.
Has been destroyed.
What you should be worried about is not Chaz Reinhold, who's in the Hall of Fame. What you should be worried about is you're getting sloppy. Now, if you sit there and expect me to go out on a limb and try to pull off the greatest crash of all time, I gotta know that your head's right. There is no room for error. Secret
Never
Service.
Never settle for second
consequences.
Yeah. If I do this, I don't want to half-ass it. I want to
plan.
All right, partner. We'll start steaming tonight, okay?
Sounds good.
Me about line six.
Okay.
Come here. Okay. Let's do our pregame.
What do you got?
A few articles on Secretary Cleary's economic policies. There's also a roster of key family members. A glossary. Sounds like sex to these people. I love it.
Harvard, Kennedy School of Government, a mom, Kennedy Cherry, blah. Daughters, one son. I get it.
Good work.
Good.
backstory.
A brother from New Hampshire. What that's your cat
face. Sick of that.
They're from Vermont. And let's have an emerging maple syrup conglomerate.
Stupid, we don't know anything about maple syrup.
I happen to know everything there is to know about maple syrup. I love maple syrup. I love maple syrup on pancakes. I love it on pizza. I want to take maple syrup and put a little bit in my hair when it's had a rough week. What do you think holds it up, Slick? It's the first quarter of the big game. You want to toss up a Hail Mary. I like to be pimps from Oakland or cowboys from Arizona, but it's on Halloween. Grow up, Peter Pan. Count Chocula. Look, I've been to a million weddings. Guess what? Rocked them all. Around the house, Aunt Liz sends her best. She couldn't make it.
An ally has been slain.
I know. She's dead.
From the grave. She sends her best. From the grave, we've become extremely spiritual.
My journey
ever since she passed. So much for your kindness.
Reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is
my place is at the top.
As you all know, Ray and Christina are quite the sailing enthusiasts. In that light, they want to exchange vows.
So here's what happened on episode 7 of the first season of Angie Tribeca.
My name's Vic Deacons, but you can call me Vic Deacons.
First, Angie needed a break.
The job is getting to you. You're wound too tight.
I could kill you for saying that.
So Giles and Tanner decided to partner up.
So what are we doing here? Are we partners or what?
Why do you have to put a label on everything? In France, cops have all kinds of partners and no one thinks twice.
To investigate the death of a golf pro.
Some kind of seasoning on here. It must be sprinkled.
Okay. Go get us seats in here. We're not too near the bridal party. I'm gonna go drop this box of fresh Wyoming air.
And if you see any pot pigs, get your hands off them. Throw them over there.
Consider it done.
Your turret has been destroyed.
Fondue set.
Your inhibitor
has been destroyed. The present you're holding is a sterling silver fondue set. John Ryan.
Claire Cleary. So how do you know that? You're so Cleary. What's that?
Knife set.
German.
Very nice.
And that?
Cotton linens. Egyptian.
Ooh. What about that?
Which they'll probably never use because it's somewhere.
Okay.
This? It's a module. And then which one's in there? Lacking in. Who's it from?
You have a gift.
Yeah, unfortunately, my powers only apply to you for consumer products.
Well, you know, it's crucial. You are this is John Ryan.
People helping people is powerful stuff.
You're a sick
man.
So many people are genius. Okay. So what angle are you going to play here?
I'm going to go with the balloon animal display for the kids. And then when she comes close, she's like, guess who's a broken man? Haunted past. That's it.
Excellent.
How about you?
I'm going to dance with the little flower girl. I might be a charter member of Oprah's book club.
It's all deadly.
Yes.
See you in a little.
Call the
truck. There it is. What happened? All right. Jeremy's a little tired right now, so why don't we do something like, let's say a giraffe?
I just want a bicycle!
What? Why are you yelling at me?
Whatever, make me a bicycle, clown!
I'm gonna make it bicycle. I don't wanna make it bicycle.
Shut your mouth, funny guy, and make it.
Got it?
Last week I did the exact replica to scale of Whitney Field. Honest to God, I don't have anywhere to put it.
Okay, then I'll take a sports car.
How about a dance?
A
That's what I really wanted.
Secretary been married?
30 years next year.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Yeah. Well, we're faithful for two of them. Enjoy the party.
Secretary Cleary, John Ryan.
Hi, John.
I just wanted to tell you how much I enjoyed your position paper on economic expansion in Micronesia.
My position paper?
Read it while I was selling my book to Bermuda.
Sailor? Good man. Take a seat.
Oh, thanks.
You didn't have to catch my speech. Paraguay and Denton on display, I should.
Are you kidding me? I thought it was great. Your argument for the inverse ratio of capitalization to debt is genius. Now, we can just get Congress not to be so short-sighted.
Yes! Well, fun, short-sighted.
John, they say you and I hang out to the deck and light up a couple of cigars. Stogies?
Yeah.
Why not?
Just that we lost a lot of the good men out there. I'm sorry. Gordon, I think I gotta go get some fresh air. Thank you so much for the dance, and it was wonderful to meet you. I wish I was stronger.
John, seem like an astute man.
Thank you.
Maybe you can help explain something to me. See that young man out there on the dock?
Sure.
It's my son Todd. 22 years old, the whole world in front of him. Every advantage in life, advantages I never had.
That's not exactly
true. He had the same advantages I had, which is a hell of a lot of advantages. Here's my question. What's he got to be so more lonesome about?
Maybe he hasn't found something to believe in.
Oh, he says he believes in art. But all I've seen him do is dribble his own blood on a canvas and smear it around with a stick.
You know, some people call that art.
It's crap. But I have a public service obligation to reflect that. Maybe he's just trying to find his own way, his own path. I mean, you cast a pretty big shadow.
Jay-Z, Weird Al Yankovic, Harry Potter, if he existed, the whore on the street, your mother, they're all mine. Let my hands in your hands. Let my cheek.
What's going on?
I faked our deaths.
Who the hell are you, man?
Christina wants to talk to you.
My name's Vic Deacons.
You see more money. The only good idea is to let me.
What is a hyper binge? Well, this is. And here's everything that happened on season one of Angie Tribeca.
Someone once told me that true love is a soul's recognition of its counterpoint in another. And I think that that's a very rare thing in this world. And I think it's something to be valued. And I'm just really happy that my big sister's found it.
Congratulations, Chris. Oh, that was amazing.
It was really great. We should probably head back so they're not looking for us.
I always knew my first time would be on a beach.
First time?
You're a virgin?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Jeremy, we're gonna be so happy together. I love you.
I'm sorry?
I love you.
Hey, fella.
How you doing?
Listen, we gotta go meet Travis.
Okay. It was great to meet you.
Oh, my God.
I'm looking all over for you. I gotta get out of here pronto. I got a stage 5 clinger.
I need more time.
Did you hear what I just said to you? Stage 5, virgin, clinger. Let's go. I'm going to start the car. I'm serious. Let's go. I don't think that you're appreciating the urgency here. Not only is she a virgin, she's totally off the reservation. I'm terrified of this broad.
There you are.
Hey, Gloria. Wow. What a coincidence. I was just singing your praises. This is John Ryan.
Oh, hi.
Yeah.
So my family and a few friends were all going by to our little place on the shore, and it would be so great if you guys came.
Really? I am
sort of wonderful.
Well, it does. It sounds very nice. But I'm flattered that you would even think of me to include me in something like that, Gloria. Thank you. It kills me, however, to have to tell you I'm sorry. I just, timing something. I won't be able to make it.
Why? It's
going to
be so much fun!
It's going to be so much fun!
I'm sure it will be fun for the people that are going. I unfortunately can't go. I don't have this monkey suit. I don't have any clothes.
No, we have everything you need.
Problem solved.
The problem's not solved.
You listen.
Oh, cool. I'm going to run it by my dad.
These seats are excellent, but unfortunately, for tomorrow night.
No!
She looked
at you. Nice. Let's take for Paula's birthday in the kitchen.
Cool. I'm gonna run it by my dad.
Go get on ice. Yeah, don't ask. Don't.
Train's gone. We gotta get on.
Oh, that's terrific. Why don't you just feed me to the lions?
What?
Step on my head when I'm drowning. What a great friend. What do you mean, what? John, this is completely against the rules. You have a wedding and a reception to seal the deal, period. There's no overtime.
Oh, no overtime?
No.
What about the Chang wedding 3 years ago?
Oh, that's bullshit.
Yeah, I forgot about that. 2 a.m., you drive me 50 miles to watch you and some chick play Mahjong with their grandmother? Their retirement home?
Yeah, completely different situation.
How?
You mean how? She was a very, very family-oriented girl. And she was very into her grandmother. They're very family-oriented.
Give me a break.
That was my first Asian.
This requires a steady hand.
You better lock it up.
No, you lock it up.
Lock it up. Lock it up. Lock it up.
Please. We mean so much to me, please.
Look at the way he's
doing. I do my best work.
You know he doesn't like me, John. He's trying to treat a treasure. To be honest with you, my taxes aren't exactly me.
Oh, come on. You're so paranoid.
He's threatened by the way I dance. Damn it. Why don't I go showing off like that?
Mercy.
Now I'm all over his radar. Stupid.
You're not that good a dancer.
Oh, please. You and I both know I'm a phenomenal dancer. Now I know you're lying through your teeth. You'll do anything to get me to go on this thing, even if I have to walk right into the lion's den.
It's
like a kid at Toys R Us. I can't be around.
Oh, get off your high horse. Stop judging people.
You take off the light wig. You stop judging me. I don't want to be around someone who's a nut job. You want to hang out with Clear, the boyfriend, and Sybil? By all means, I'm not going.
Let me lay it out for you in simple chaplain version. You're going.
Let me break it down for you so you understand. I'll hold your hand like a small child.
I'm not going.
Yes, you are.
You can go.
You're going to be the last of your life.
No, I'm not.
He'd love you to come.
Yes!
Yes!
Oh, I'm going
to you.
You tell people to hold that for 45 minutes. I don't have any pop
pills left. Gentlemen, everything okay?
Great.
Okay?
Yep.
You know, we were thinking about a game of touch football.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Good family tradition.
A little base camp, why not?
Great.
Don't forget to stretch, guys. We're going to be in the field at 10.
Want the noise brought on you? Because here it comes.
What the noise brought on? Here it comes. Hide the ball, my job.
Ready, set, run, hunt, fight.
Way to bring it. No, I just saw you had it.
Shut up!
Guy, anticipate that rush.
Cool. No, of course it didn't. You did a great job.
What happened, Tubbs?
I think he's on steroids. I'm trying to cover a fucking racehorse.
Don't worry about it. We'll burn him with the post.
All right, guys, bring it in.
Boom, 17! Boom, 17!
Oh, you're gonna cover.
Like, white on red.
All right, I like my odds here. I'm gonna give you a little warning. I'm going down.
Top row! Red 7, red 7, red 7!
Look for me after this play. I'll be the guy holding the ball.
Stop!
Yeah. I don't know what red 7 means.
Top row!
I don't. What is hot round? You just go stand on the other side, please.
No, I'm just getting over here. Down.
Executed.
Big tree fall hard, man.
How many fingers I got?
An ally has been slain.
Come on, Pepe. How many fingers I got? Come on, I got four. I got this five.
Serves him right after that throw.
Hey, Baba Ganoush.
I don't know what I don't want to get into me, Secretary.
I do. Five generations of large family breeding.
Your father is the
foolish. You okay?
Jeremy, sit this play out.
Todd, come on in.
You must be joking.
It's not like I want to be murdering my fellow YouTubers. The exposure is amazing.
Let us begin, shall we? Okay, this is happening.
Here we go!
I like good old-fashioned conversation. Two people silently texting each other.
We're talking about the end of the world.
Everyone's gonna die.
I want love.
No match found.
You could try dudes.
You were attacked by college humor, but don't worry. They're all like 30 and out of shape.
Oh, we're back.
I thought that centaurs were real.
I wasn't sure!
You all are out of your damn mind!
That's enough out of you, potty mouth!
I'll be there for you.
Working. Oh, God.
Yeah. Let's get jiggy with it.
What?
Once in a while, right?
Would that make you love me? Moondog 7-Eleven, 42-13. Come on,
Hunter! Oh, I got you.
No, you didn't.
You're cheating! Oh my God, your brother is down again.
This is deal.
I don't know what's gonna happen, you guys.
Nature versus nurture, lot. Nature always wins.
You feel touch every time I look over, you're on your ass again.
I didn't hear my lungs like screaming at you.
Oh, now you're gonna blame me? Because you're not athletic enough to stay on your 2 feet?
And only needs one shot.
Let's take a daiquiri timeout.
Daiquiris.
Sure, Mom.
Don't blame me. That just makes it worse. Oh, great. Game's over. Satisfied. You got everyone on you now. Get all the attention.
You should have played with your underwear. Okay. Peace requires.
requires a steady hand. Don't worry, an
ally has been slain.
It was like 8 hours ago. You were a shy little virgin, and now you're ordering it in panties. I'm just trying to catch up with you.
Where's my little friend?
I'm sorry, he's tired. He's tired. He's in timeout. He's in timeout. Gloria, please. I'm exhausted. I've had a very long day. I had your sister's boyfriend try and help me up and down the field all afternoon. My leg's cut and bleeding. I'm not really in the mood for this. Ow! Jesus Christ!
My father warned me about people like you, Jeremy. And there's another notch on your belt.
Is it not like that? What are you talking? It's not like that.
Really? Then what's it like, Jeremy, huh?
Ow! Ah! Ow! No! Wait! It's just that I'm feeling very strongly that we're only starting to express ourselves in a physical, sexual, specifically way. That's it! Wait! I play some catch-up on finding out who's inside here. Okay?
You're amazing!
Change for dinner. Okay.
I won't lead us astray.
No, she's the... I just...
Shut down.
Belt.
I didn't wear a belt.
Never lose focus.
Very powerful man.
So I'm president of the environmental defense.
And I'll pick up this little sea otter and
wipe off the oil.
Alright, you gotta step this up already. I'm gonna give you the damn eye drops. I don't want this. Do you want to be with her? A few of these things in his drink, and he'll be going down our toilet seat for the next 24 hours.
An ally has been slain. Has been slain.
The whiskers. And the oil's flapping. He's. Give me the eye drops. Thank you.
I always take the high ground. We must press on.
And ask that you bless the entire Cleary family.
Say that 5 times fast.
You can't do a soul sustaining scan.
It actually looks terrific. Maybe I'll actually try some when I get the sensation back in my face from the football game.
Yeah, Jeremy, I'm sorry. I just, I understand the competitive streak.
I'm seeing a Buddhist.
Not just any Buddhist. His Holiness, the Dalai Lama, he's a good friend.
Shop fries and get the guaranteed lowest prices on hundreds of items. These incredible deals are only available with Fry's promo codes. Sign up now for instant savings of up to 50%.
Holiness, the Dalai Lama, he's
been traffic. Because when I go back to town, I'm actually going to see an orthopedist about what you did to my back. And not just any orthopedist. I'm going to see a Dr. Epstein who specializes
in the whole thing. Hey, Sat, how long have you and Claire been seeing each other?
Claire and I, sweetheart, a couple years.
Actually, we started dating while we were doing Habitat for Humanity.
Sure. Pretty soon, we'll be getting married. Yep.
Well, not too soon.
And then, of course, you can challenge the tonight.
You have been slain.
John, I saw you on the dance floor. You look pretty good.
Well, thanks a lot. Really just got lucky. I was more in the zone than anything else. It was booze dancing.
Sorry, guys, I forgot. How are you guys connected to the family?
Uncle Ned's kid.
Faster than my arrow? I think not.
You know, Uncle Ned, Aunt Liz's brother. Ned and Liz?
No, I don't know.
Never
so mistakes. Jeremy. You and your brother, don't you?
That's right.
It's great. Bunch of capitalists. The backbone of the system. New pioneer.
So is it just about
No. No, it's about investing in companies that are ethically and morally defensible.
Or like what? Give me an example.
Like what, bro? Someone has to pay for the lap dances for the big guy.
You're shrugging around. Feels so good when he jokes.
What's this company called?
Shirts and Pants.
Holy Shirts and Pants. It's a little corny and obvious, but what do you get out of this stuff, right?
That's a hell of a good project. I'm going to mention something to the comment secretary.
That would be terrific. That would be great.
My husband was an enemy terrorist of state for President Franklin Roosevelt.
That must have been so thrilling, FDR.
FDR is a wonderful president.
I'm so tired.
All right.
Let's see how how close they can get.
What an athlete. Tremendous.
And also, you know, that shouldn't be dead.
He's at home now.
Molly, let's not go there again.
Actually, Todd is an amazing painter. He's going to the Rhode Island School of Design.
Well, that's a great school. Congratulations, Todd. That's really impressive. RISD.
Yeah, Dad used to think I'd be a political liability. You know, in case he ever ran for president.
Oh, Tom. Actually, truth be told, polling shows the majority of the American people would ultimately empathize with our situation.
What is our situation, Dad?
You're a homo.
For God's sakes, will you put Mom to bed already?
Okay. Mommy, we've had a long day.
I can do it myself, asshole.
Wow. I'll be in my room painting.
Stand together.
Homo things.
You just go right ahead, Toddy.
Wonderful scallops.
We are one.
I think I'm going to get some air.
I'll get some air if you want some.
Excuse me.
Can't walk away from people with it.
An ally has been slain.
Seem like lovely tits.
William doesn't give a shit about my tits.
Well, I do darn like him. But Mrs. Perry, this is pretty soon.
You've been playing cat and mouse with me ever since you came.
Here I go. Mrs. Cleary.
Kitty Cat.
I'm sorry, Kitty Cat. Are you out of
your fucking mind? I'm not letting you out of this room until you feel.
An ally has been slain. Enemy killing spree.
Well, they feel really nice.
The Surface Pro, it's like a multi-purpose piece of equipment for me. The fact that you can travel with it as a laptop and use it as a drawing tool, it's the only one I need.
In a shack in Guam. Not by choice.
Stop kidding with me, Todd. You almost had me. Come on.
Two,
I
got this.
John. I need to talk to you.
An ally has been
What's
slain.
What's wrong with you? Why you got the weird look
An enemy
your face?
Has been slain.
Claire's mom is mad. Well, snap out of it.
What, a hot older woman made you feel her pants?
Violent.
Why'd you try getting jacked off under the table from the whole damn family? That's a real problem. Jackass. What were they like anyway?
Where is she? She's still in the house?
What is wrong with you?
What do you mean what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
No, what's wrong with you?
No, what's wrong with you? You're projecting.
Drop it.
You drop it. You stop projecting on me. Why don't you go enjoy yourself while I go ice my balls and spit up blood?
Drop it!
Team player. Room.
Jam, you got
I do my
fun.
Best work from Jam. Afar.
You see me? The family dog is dead. I can wake him up.
An enemy has been slain.
Conscious.
It's a family. You're picking it up. You got the sweet old grandma who's like really sweet with her like little like white hair, but then she's kind of mean. You're like, she's so old and she's not gonna change now. I'm so ready to embarrass myself with that stupid joke I told.
Are you kidding? That was so funny.
No.
Yeah, you're like
a
crazy guest.
I
think he's part of the family already.
This doesn't sound that great. That felt horrible.
No, it's cute.
The crazy guest who thinks he's like a part of the family is going to be great stuff. What is that?
Yeah. You
and
your PA? You're so stuck in
strike.
Yeah?
Check that out.
Okay, no, I'll be right
here. My arrow and my bait knot.
You could just cut that cycle battle bullshit that your mom tells you, okay?
An ally has been slain.
Hey, you want to help me out? Do you? Do you, kid? Why don't you go get me a 7-Up, okay? All right, because I think I'm... destroyed.
So here's what happened on episode 1 of the first season of Angie Tribeca. First, the lieutenant wanted to see Angie.
But he doesn't look happy.
He never looks happy.
Then she got a new...
thought I would have noticed that there was a moment. There was no moment.
I made you a painting.
What? I call the painting Celebration.
That cycle battle there should be the market, okay?
Hey, you wanna help me out?
Do you? Do you, kid?
Why don't you go get me a 7-Up?
Okay? Alright, because I think I'm.
Thinking about what you said before, and I think the problem is I am not being adventurous enough for you.
Lord, I'm pretty sure that is not what I've been saying to you.
Baby, I'm gonna make all your fans. My room is steady.
But this is not bad.
Never.
Exactly.
I'm gonna go. You can't go.
Watch me. Watch me take this on down the road.
Look, you believe Corey is gonna shit thing. And it's gonna go into crisis lockdown mode here at the house.
I don't give up.
Well, obviously, we have an Angie Tribeca meme-a-thon on TBS.
Down mode here at the house.
pouring sweat in, was shoved into my mouth, and then was duct taped over it.
Let's talk about it. I'm a good listener.
I'm not in a place to discuss what happened.
Okay?
I felt like Jodie Foster and the accused last night. I'm gonna go home, see Dr. Finkelstein, and I'm gonna tell him we got a whole new bag of issues we can forget about Mom for a while. I'm gonna go.
Suit yourself. Rule number one.
How selfish you are.
I need you.
A friend in need is a pest. I'll stick it out with you. Because you're desperate.
I need the big guy.
I'm gonna try to give you a little bit more time. Because somebody can't close.
Fair enough.
But if you want my help, you gotta listen. Number one, stop being a pussy. Number two, make a move. Number three, you know it. Could you fucking sir for me?
This is a top off?
Here's what's gonna happen. Tonto. Team Asabi's gonna have some flavor. I'm gonna choose not to eat with you.
We're not gonna eat together?
No. I like to recharge my batteries and shut down the engines and get myself back to neutral. When the meal's over with, I will talk to you. I don't want to get into what happened last night because it's only going to make me mad. Let's get through today. Let's keep our eye on the prize. Let's focus and let's close some ass.
Noted. Can I tell you something? Are you getting angry? I love you. Yeah, you.
Hello.
Trapster. It's Sack.
How was the wedding?
The bachelor party, of course, rocked. We got Heidi, a couple of those fucking sluts from the environmental group. Remember them?
No way. Did you tap that again?
Once in my place, then once back in the cab.
Damn.
How's Claire? Still trying to figure out what she's doing with her life?
Claire? She's, whatever.
I don't know. She's saving the world one maladjusted period of time, but that'll all change when we're married. Because I want a wife. I don't want a fucking martyr, right?
I hear that, my friend.
Hey, man, listen. I got... Do you remember that private detective we used to set up that fucking Shearson Lehman prick?
The big sleazy, Tommy Gufano. He's a WAP genius.
Yes! I need you to get some dirt on these two guys, John and Jeremy Ryan. They're brothers from New Hampshire. They got some sort of NPO called Holy Shirts and Pants. I will check into them.
Excellent, bro. You the man.
Oh, he's still not doing very well.
Oh, man.
Shit.
has arrived.
Environmental's also a hunter.
It's kind of an interesting combination.
I hunt quail, Jeremy. They're overpopulated in this region, and they're decimating the grubworm population. You got a fucking problem with that?
Not nearly as much as I do with the attire that you have on. What is your general point of view towards everybody? Well, let's go kill some birds. I'm psyched. Have you even shot one of these things before?
Whole 17 years we've known each other. I've been sneaking off to go on little hunting trips around the world. No, I don't even know what the fuck a quail is.
That feels totally ridiculous. It's like, why do I have to be in camouflage so the big bad quail doesn't see me?
No. Why can't we hunt something cool like a hawk or an eagle, something with some talons?
That'd be awesome. You mean it's up like big game, even like a gorilla? A rhinoceros, a fucking human being. I'll get you jacked up. It's a little heavy.
I mean,
you're hunting a human being right now, most dangerous game. Like a worthy adversary. Not a human being that's armed, but a clever human being who knows the jungle.
Like we're the ones. Something not right about these guys.
What do you mean?
I mean, it's time to send them home.
Back. Don't do anything crazy.
You just relax. I'm just gonna scare them all back.
All right. Just came by and said we're gonna take a little bike ride and then we're gonna come back and check up on you and take care of him, okay? I want you to get my little angel up and running. Hang in there.
I hope you flip your bike over and knock your two front teeth out, you selfish son of a bitch. You leave me in the trenches taking grenades, John.
In the summertime, when the weather is hot,
philosophy.
I'm watching my stories, Mom.
Is that what you get paid to do?
It's exactly what I get paid to do.
Look, I want to know where Claire is.
She took a bike ride down to the beach.
With who?
With that fella from the wedding that everyone seemed to be
welcome
so
to
fond
Summer's
of.
Rift.
So you're a venture capitalist. What does that mean?
30 seconds until the
new
year's
start.
You don't sound very enthused.
Oh, no, it's just...
You know, things start happening, and you go down a road, and you think it's just for a little while, and you get caught up in it, and get kind of into it. You don't even have time to really ask questions
Minions
about it before you know you're living a life that you didn't set out to or that you intended to. You know what I mean?
Yes, I do.
The sun always rises.
I think that there are some great things that I'd like to do that maybe I'm capable of, hopefully.
Oh, yeah?
You're not that
young. I'm sorry.
Give me your hand.
I know it's me.
Okay.
I'm not gonna bite you.
You want full speed?
You're never gonna hit me. I mean, I'm pretty quick.
Let me get settled before you go.
You gotta wait until I put the band. So what about you? Is that a good thing?
Yes, it's a good thing.
I must not fall.
You sound very enthused.
I am. That's how everyone feels before they're about to get married. Anything? Yeah, no, don't answer that. That's my rationalization and my hope to answer that.
The only haters I've got time for are the haters that hate on my haters.
Pop star. Now play.
I must not fall.
They'll have to get through me.
I know that we said we were gonna wait, but given the spirit of this weekend, well,
they will be something. Ever vigilant.
Claire and I are getting married. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Way to go. Way to go.
Claire, you never told me.
Two of the great American family.
Dad.
You just came in one room?
Yeah.
Congratulations, young man. Welcome to the family.
Look, Kevin, I'm sorry. You win some, you lose some, right? Let's go home.
No, I'm not. I can't do that.
What are you talking about? Good. I mean, I believe that she was a
first light approaches.
It hurts to be lying to like that. It's a horrible feeling to feel that way. But I, you know, was looking to take advantage of something too, so could I really feel that bad? It's not like I was who I am. You know what I'm saying? So fair play. And let's be honest with each other here, okay? Let's put all the parts to the
table.
She's
full
of frustration. This broad's about three ways towards the future. You want
to
know what? It turns me on. Because you want to know what that means for me. Maybe I'm a fucking crazy.
That's right. Maybe Jeremy's a little nuts. Maybe there's something about me that I don't know. I was a surprise. I know it's not on the surface. Now I had an imaginary friend when I was a kid. His name is Shiloh. We used to play checkers with each other every day. Bless his heart. Is that abnormal? There's something odd in that. Maybe that's what it takes to make you feel like you're connected to somebody. I don't know. I know when that redhead starts getting poopy, that's something that's alive inside. You're a really enlightened cat, and I like that about you. I think you're a special, special man.
Come in for the real thing. Get in here for the real thing. I love you. You're a sweet man.
An enemy has been slain. Ever vigilant.
Actually, I need to talk to you about this. We're not here. Maybe we want to sit back on the swing.
Why don't you tell her, John?
I don't know what's going on. I'm playing catch up, too.
Zach! What are you doing?
Remembering yet? You remember yet?
Are you okay?
They're not who they say they are, Claire. Those aren't even their real names.
No, everything we told you.
Why?
I don't understand what you're saying.
Claire, they crash weddings. They crash weddings so they can sleep.
An enemy has been slain.
Everything that they've told us is a piece of shit. All of it is like, don't you fucking get up.
We need to stop! Is that true?
It's not true.
It's a yes or no question.
I know, but it's come.
Yes or no?
You may
out of you, Claire.
An ally has been slain.
Come on, let's go.
Killing spree. Shut down.
Sweetheart. I will definitely call you back later, then.
Come on, wrap it up.
What?
Rampage.
I can't do this anymore. It's been several months, and you haven't heard from her. She hasn't returned her phone calls. She's never responded to one of your letters. Handygram. God knows what happened to Kipnick and Donna. If she didn't think this, I know you're not raising that goddamn thing. I think it's very obvious at this point that she just flat out. Listen to me. I can't go.
Why?
Because I can't go, because I have a schedule, because I have...
What is your problem? For the past couple months, you've been a ghost. I can't find you any place, and now I come to you with an idea. I put myself on the line, you shoot it down with your negativity. Your goddamn negativity. I don't need it. I'm an idea man. I thrive on enthusiasm. Don't take the wind out of my sails.
Buddy, you know I love you. I don't hate to see you like this, but we gotta look at reality here. There's gonna be Secret Service at this thing. They have pictures of us. There's not a shot in hell.
I will protect you.
Hey, hey, now.
Approaches.
Your turret has been destroyed.
You have been slain.
Thank you.
not fall.
An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain. Shut down.
Rally to me. Approaching. Ever vigilant.